everyone, welcome to homeschool. And today we are back with the chapter electricity, and we have discussed many concepts in electricity. All basic ones are over, right? See, we got to know what do you mean by electric current. Later we got to know the importance of potential difference, how it can be generated, right? And we have also discussed a very, very important law in electricity, that is Ohm's law, its verification, and we discussed many numericals also. So today we are with a concept called resistance. We will discuss everything about a resistance, the meaning of the word resistance, where it has come from, how resistance is caused in a conductor, and then the meaning of the word resistivity, on what factors this resistance can depend on, and also the numericals on resistivity. So this much we are going to discuss in today's class. So without wasting our time, let us start the topic resistance. So resistance, it is indicated with R, isn't it? So where did you hear this word resistance? In case of Ohm's law. So what is our Ohm's law? It is nothing but V is directly proportional to I, where if you have to remove this proportionality constant, we introduce V is equal to RI, right? So this proportionality constant, that is R, we call it as resistance. Resistance, isn't it? And we can also write this formula as V by I is equal to R. So this is what we studied in case of Ohm's law. So we have a lot of meaning behind this letter R, right? It's very important in case of electric circuits, right? So let us understand the meaning of the word resistance. So what do you mean by resistance normally? It is nothing but opposition to the flow of current. What is the definition of resistance? Opposition to a flow of current. Right? So current always flows in an electric circuit. Say here and there would be some opposition for the flow of current. Say if I have to draw a small circuit here, say this is a battery, positive terminal and a negative terminal, right? So here we have a small circuit. So current direction is this, positive to negative, whereas electrons direction is negative to positive. So we know the conventional way of indicating the direction of electric current, right? Fine. So the flow of current in the circuit is not smooth. You know, the moment potential difference is created across a battery, across the ends of a wire, electric current starts moving. But the movement of electric current is not smooth. Here and there would be some disturbances. Okay. Some force is there that opposes to the flow of current. You know, something is happening inside this wire, conducting wire, that is actually opposing the flow of current. Okay, so this opposition to a flow of current is called as resistance. Clear, everybody? So current will not flow that much smoothly in a circuit. Here and there some disturbances would be there, and those disturbances are called resistance here. Right? Fine. And you know, from a formula, we can say that R is inversely proportional to I. Yes or no? Say, observe, R is inversely proportional to I. So what does this mean? As R increases, as resistance increases in a circuit, you know, current decreases. Current decreases. Say the vice versa also. As R decreases, current can increase. The flow of current can increase in a circuit, right? If you have lots of disturbances in a metallic wire or in a circuit, what happens? Flow of current is restricted. current will not flow that much easily and that much smoothly, right? So this is what the meaning. As resistance increases, as the disturbances and obstacles increases in the way where the current will flow, you know what happens? The amount of current flow always decreases because lots of disturbances are there which is resisting, which is opposing the flow of current, which is restricting the flow of current. Okay? And if there are less disturbances, less opposition in a circuit, you know, current can flow very smoothly and more electric current you would observe in a circuit. Right? So this is actually very, very, very important to remember. Right? Both resistance and current is always inversely proportional. If resistance increases, current decreases. If resistance decreases, current increases. Right? Fine. See people, now let us try to understand how this resistance is created in a circuit. Why it is actually restricting the flow of current? Why it is opposing electric current's flow? You know, let us study the reason how it can be generated. So I am going to discuss about how resistance is caused or how resistance is created or caused, one and the same, right? See, normally what happens in a metallic wire is, say this is a metallic wire, right? Through metallic wire only you can produce electric current, because in the metals free electrons are there, they keep moving, right? All that we have discussed. So let me take this metallic wire. I'm talking about inside part of metallic wire. Okay, so inside. Say electrons are moving, right? So from negative end in a metallic wire, the electrons are moving. But you know, electrons will not have easy passage in a wire. Why? Because you have lots of atoms in between and you will have some impurities in between. Right? It's a metal. Metal never be in a pure state. It will have some impurities in it. Okay? Some other elements would be there. Some other metal atoms would be there. Whatever may be. Right? So, in the way of electrons, you would find lot of atoms, lot of impurities and every other stuff. So, what happens is the electron will try to, say, imagine this is one atom. Atoms are everywhere randomly arranged, right? And there would be so many impurities also. Say, imagine the electron is coming. So, you will have chances of this electron hitting the atom, or it may hit the impurity, or whatever the atoms or impurities are there in its way, it will hit them, right? This is what we call collision. Collision in the sense what? Say for example, this chalk piece, I'm hitting onto my hand, right? This is what we call collision. So collision should happen between electron and other atoms and impurities. So whenever electron goes and hits certain things, obviously its speed, its flow will get stopped. Yes or no? Say this is just like a speed car getting stopped near speed breakers. Say you are giving acceleration. Compare acceleration with voltage. Right? Voltage is what? The push. It gives a push to move electrons. So whenever you give acceleration in your car, the car moves in a speed. So that moving car in a speed is nothing but flow of electrons. You are giving push here in a battery. So the electrons are flowing in a speed. Okay. So acceleration you have given in a car, your car is moving with much speeder. But in between you have got speed breakers. What will happen to the speed of a car? Decreases. So whenever a speed breaker comes, you know what? You will put a brake, car stops, or car actually becomes very slow in moving, right? So the same thing here. Electron is coming in a certain speed, but here and there are lot of other atoms and impurities in a metallic wire, definitely. So whenever electron collides with them, automatically its movement will get stopped to some extent. It moves with less speed. It cannot move in a faster way. right? So when the electrons movement has become slightly stopped, or if it has become slow, then how can you expect electric current moving in a speed, right? So when electrons flow only, no, electric current gets generated. Movement of electrons only we call electric current, right? So this is how the resistance, this is what, see, opposition is created here for what? For movement of current, for movement of electrons. So this opposition is what we call resistance. Okay, fine. So let me note down the point here. Resistance is caused due to the collisions. Collisions in the sense what, guys? It is hitting, right? Collisions between electrons and other atoms, impurities, etc. in a metallic wire of an electric circuit. Okay, so this is how here and there disturbances would be found in a metallic wire that makes the flow of electrons little slow. Okay, that's how, you know, we are creating a disturbance to the flow of current. That disturbance only we are calling it as resistance. Fine, everything is clear, right? Okay, and now you must understand the meaning of certain terms here. Clear? We all know, what do you mean by conductor, right? So conductor is the one that can pass the electric current very easily. Conductor is the one which shows easy movement of electrons. That means in a conductor, you will have very less resistance. Okay, so you will have very less chances of electron colliding with other atoms and impurities. So when you have less chances of electron colliding with other atoms and impurities, electrons can flow freely, right, to some extent in a faster way. Okay, so such a material is called as conductor. Okay, so what I can define as a conductor? Conductor is a material where electrons flow easily due to very less resistance. Okay, I am giving definition of conductor in the words of resistance. Okay, in connection with resistance, actually, right? Now you got to know what is resistance. So in the definition, I am including that word called resistance, right? So what is a conductor? It is that material where electrons flow easily. Why electrons are flowing easily? Because you have very, very less resistance. That means the flowing electrons, the moving electrons do not collide that much with other atoms and impurities. Clear? Fine. And now you have something called resistor. These definitions are important, guys. You should compare the definitions of one term and another term. That is the main motto of the concept that I'm telling you now, right? So what is a resistor? Resistors are also conductors only. They are also conductors. The material can conduct electricity, can carry electricity from one point to another point, no doubt. Conductors with appreciable amount of resistance. Conductors with appreciable amount of resistance is called resistors. A new term, isn't it? Resistors are nothing but conductors only. But these conductors have slight resistance in them. Okay, they have moderate resistance in them, not the resistance very much less as conductor. Okay, compared to a conductor, these guys have little more resistance. So such a materials are called resistors. Okay, so actually resistors are the guy which will oppose the flow of current, which can actually control the flow of current. You know what? In the electrical circuits, resistance is needed. Okay, you have to control the current in the circuits. If you cannot control the current, if you cannot slow down the flow of a current, what would happen is the whole circuit may get burst up. Okay, or sometimes the conducting wires will catch fire. Okay, so to avoid such accidents, you know, in the circuit, we will use the so-called resistors. What do we use in a circuit, guys? We will use a so-called resistors. So whenever I use a resistor in a circuit, this is how I indicate resistance or resistor. This is a symbol for resistor. Okay, say for example, this is my device. Okay, let me take here. Okay, so here I have some device. Right. See, this device does not need too much of current. See, voltage is very high. When the voltage is very high, electrons move in a much faster way. And if the electric current is more, if it goes more to this particular device, imagine the device will get spoiled. It doesn't require much current. Then what I can do in between, in the way, I can use so-called resistors. Resistors are some materials only, but these resistors will slow down the passage of current. Okay, so current is coming, so it's coming very fastly. Resistors will tell, hold on. It disturbs the flow of current. It disturbs the speed with which current is coming. You know, so it settles how much ever current is necessary for this particular device or bulb, that much only this resistor will send. Okay, so that is the purpose of resistor. That is necessary. Resistance to create in a circuit is very much necessary sometimes, guys. Okay, so that's why we use so-called resistors in a circuit. Okay, you know what? Every house in India is provided with 220 volts of voltage. Okay, so our power supply in a home has this much of voltage. Okay, so from here only we give connection to all our electrical equipments. Okay, so from here we give connection to our AC, from here we give connection to our TV, our refrigerators, and you know, if you want to charge a mobile, you know, you should use the current from this particular source. Okay, from here only we drag all the wires, we make circuits and we connect to each and every equipment. Right, this is a basic idea. Fine. And you see, voltage is same. That means same amount of current will flow, no, to every equipment. Yes or no? The amount of current flown in AC is equal to the amount of current flown in TV. That is equal to the amount of current flowing in a refrigerator or whatever. Water heater, bulb, lights, etc. But some equipment needs less current. Some equipment needs more current. Yes or no? Say for example, this is connected to tube light also. Whereas the tube light and the mobile need very less current. If more current has flown to mobile and tube light, what would happen? They will get burst up. More current is not necessary. Less amount of current is enough. But whereas AC, you know, you require more current. Or if you have water heater, you know, more current is required for these equipments, right? But less current is required for these equipments. But all of them are connected to the same source, so same amount of current will pass. But some need less current, some need more current. So here something must be there, no, to regulate the current for these guys. Something must be there to control the current. Something must be there to stop the flow of current here for these guys. So what is that something? Resistors. Understood the duty of resistors? Resistors are very much necessary to be there in a circuit. Okay, for some equipments. Because sometimes we need to control the current. right? So resistance is very important and resistors are very important. So whenever you indicate resistance or resistor in a circuit, we use this symbol. This means what? Resistor is connected, or some amount of resistor means what? Some amount of resistance is there. So some disturbance is there here, so that current flow will become slow. Less amount of current only can be passed to the device, so the device can be safe. So whichever devices that require less amount of current, you know, in their circuit paths, what are incorporated? Resistors are incorporated. They will get fixed. Okay, fine. So try to understand the meaning of resistors. And now, insulators. So what do you mean by insulators? Insulators are those materials with very much high resistance. With high resistance. That means, you know, these guys, so much disturbance would be there so that the electrons cannot move only. Okay. So such materials are called insulators, like plastic, rubber, plastic, rubber, etc. Okay, so these are the terms whose definitions are important. We have two more terms here. Variable resistance. Variable resistance. So what do you mean by variable resistance? You know, these variable resistance are the material which controls the flow of current without changing the voltage. Okay, say voltage will not be changed. These instruments, when kept in a circuit, what will happen? It will try to control the current. Okay, it will make the current flow slow or fast. You know, that is what we call variable resistance. So variable resistance controls the flow of current without changing the voltage. Okay, and the next word is rheostat. Rheostat is an example of variable resistance only. Okay, it is a device. Rheostat is a device that changes the resistance of a circuit. Okay. Say whenever you want more resistance, then you can create more resistance in a circuit with the help of rheostat. Whenever you want less resistance, say you want your current to be flown very fastly in a circuit, then you can always, control the rheostat. You know, with the help of rheostat, what actually happens is you can increase the resistance of a circuit, or you can also decrease the resistance of a circuit. Okay, it's a flexible device actually, which increases or decreases the resistance of a circuit so that we can control the current, flow of current, right? So these are the different terms whose meaning is very important to understand. And now, let us try to study on what factors this resistance depends on. Resistance actually depends on certain factors. Okay, so let us discuss those factors in detail. You know, resistance actually depends on four factors. Remember, the first one is length of a conductor. Length of a wire. Wire is, yes or no, in a wire only, conducting wire itself, the electricity will pass, right? So whatever disturbances are there, it has to create in a wire only. So actually resistance depends on length of a wire, right? Say for example, you have a shorter wire and you have a longer wire, right? So, in which wire you will find less disturbance and in which wire you will find more disturbance? See, electron is flowing, right? See, since the wire is very short, less disturbance you would find here because less number of atoms would be there. Wire is very small, very shorter wire, right? So, electron flow is quite okay, easier compared to this particular wire, because as the wire length increases, you know, the disturbances, the chance of creating disturbances increases more, right? See, in this, if you have like 100 atoms to create a disturbance, here you will have 1000 atoms to create a disturbance, right? Yes or no? So from this, what I can say is our resistance R is directly proportional to L. What do you mean by L? L is nothing but length of a wire, length of a conducting wire. Yes or no? More the length, more is the chance of creating disturbances, more is the resistance. Shorter is the length of a wire, lesser chances of creating a disturbances, so less amount of resistance. Okay, so more the length, more is the resistance, lesser the length, less is the resistance. So R is directly proportional to L. So now the second factor that a resistance depends is area of cross section of a wire. Area of cross section of a wire. So what do you mean by area of cross section of a wire? The width, guys, the inside part of a wire, right? Wire, you have certain gap, that hollow part. Hollow part, that inside part of a wire is called area of cross section. Okay, say if the wire is thick, thicker wire, in case of thicker wire, the area of cross section, say wire is very much thick, so you will have lots of area, there is so much hollow inside the wire. Okay, so whereas definitely here also atoms would be there, but electron can pass freely in between the atoms. There are lots of spaces between the atoms. Okay, so through the spaces, electron can pass easily. Got to know? In case of thinner wire, say thinner wire, there is no lots of space inside a wire, so you have fully packed atoms, so electron will not find space to go further, right? So here in case of thinner wire, you will expect more resistance. In case of thicker wire, you will expect less resistance, because in case of thicker wire, you will find more area of cross section, more place in a wire. It is more hollow. So you would find free spaces between the atoms for an electron to flow easily. Whereas in case of thinner wire, you know, there would not be more spaces between the atoms for an electron to flow easily. So that's the reason, more resistance. So how is our resistance is dependent on area of cross section? Inversely proportional. Yes or no? So our resistance here is inversely proportional to A. A in the sense what? Area of cross section. Area of cross section. Clear? Fine. And the third factor on which the resistance depends is nature of material. Nature of material. Okay, so resistance is different in different materials. Say, you know, in case of metals, you know, resistance is very much less. Yes or no? In case of insulators, resistance is very much high. So, a copper wire will have some resistance. Again, aluminium wire will have different kinds of resistance. Yes or no? Silver will have a kind of resistance. So, resistance always depends on nature of material. Okay? So, in different materials, different resistances are found. Okay? That's very important. In different materials will have different resistance. Okay, So this point is important. Actually, based on this, we have activity in our textbook also, that is 12.2 activity. In a circuit, if we introduce nichrome wire, how much amount of current it shows. When you introduce a bulb, you know, torch bulb, how much amount of current it shows. When you introduce, 10 watt bulb, how much current it shows, you know, there is an activity. If the resistance is very much high, less amount of current is shown in the ammeter of a circuit, right? So in case of nichrome, 10 watt bulb and, torch light, the nichrome has highest resistance. Okay, so whenever you have a nichrome wire in a circuit, okay, I'm actually talking about the activity that is there in your textbook. Okay, so here when you connect a nichrome wire, nichrome wire has very high resistance. So less current, less I is shown in the ammeter. Okay, so instead of nichrome wire, when you have torch bulb, high current is shown because resistance of this torch bulb is very, very less. Okay, 10 watt bulb resistance is in between the nichrome and torch bulb. So if you can read the activity, you will understand whatever I said now. And anyway, if you don't have any idea about the activity, leave it, right? So ultimately, what I meant to tell you is, different materials will show different resistances. If a material is showing very high resistance, in a circuit, you will find less amount of current flowing, right? If a material has very less resistance in a circuit, you will find more current flowing. That's it. That's a simple thing. Fine. And the fourth factor on which the resistance is depending on is temperature. Okay, here temperature plays a very important role. Actually, resistance and temperature are directly proportional. As you increase temperature, okay, as temperature increases, our resistance also increases. Remember this. Because imagine electrons are flowing in a conducting wire. If I increase the temperature of this conducting wire, kinetic energy of atoms increases. That means atoms will start moving, here and there randomly. They are not at rest. They start moving here and there if temperature increases. So when the atoms are starting to move randomly here and there, the electron finds more difficult to move through the atoms. Yes or no? Right? So that's the reason. As temperature increases, our resistance also increases. Clear? So these are the four factors you have to mention when the question is asked, like what factors affect the resistance. Okay? Length of a wire, area of cross section of a conducting material, nature of material, temperature. Fine. And now with these factors, let us try to figure out the formula for resistance. Okay, there is a formula for resistance which is very much helpful in calculating numericals. So very, very, very important formula it is. So we all know Ohm's law, right? From Ohm's law, we can say that V by I is equal to R. This is one formula of resistance. Try to remember. And now, from the factors, see the first factor and the second factor, right? Say R is directly proportional to L, R is inversely proportional to area of cross section. If I combine both of them, what can I write? R is proportional to L by A. Yes or no? R is directly proportional to L, R is inversely proportional to 1 by A. L into 1 by A, I can write it as L by A, right? Fine. Now, if I have to remove this proportionality sign, I should introduce a constant, right? So, R is equal to constant into L by A. Observe this constant. This constant is called rho, R-H-O, rho. Okay? Rho, or it is also called as resistivity. is also called resistivity or specific resistance. Specific resistance. Clear? Now, can you be able to derive a formula for rho or resistivity? You know, I can write, rearrange the formula. If this A in the denominator goes here, I can write Ra. This L, if it goes here, L is equal to rho. Yes, this is the formula for rho. Okay, rho is equal to Ra by L. But R is equal to rho L by A. Both the formulas are very, very, very important to remember. Clear? So try to remember, rho is nothing but specific resistance, or it is also called as resistivity. Okay, fine. And now let us try to learn the units of rho. So what is the formula of rho here? Rho is equal to Ra by L. Okay, so what is the unit of R? Unit of R is ohms. We have studied in the last class, right? So R's unit is ohm, area is meter square, okay? Length unit, standard unit is meter. So this gets cancelled. So rho's unit is ohm meter. Okay, this is the unit of rho. What is the unit of R? R's unit is just ohms. Units are also very, very important. Unit of rho is ohm meter, R is ohm. Okay, so here you must understand, what do you mean by L? Length of a wire. What do you mean by A? Area of a cross section. That is, this circular area inside a wire is called as area of cross section. Okay, and now let us try to understand what is the difference between resistance and resistivity. First, let us understand the real meaning of resistivity. If I ask you the definition of resistivity, how can you define it? It's very simple. Resistivity is nothing but a property of a material, guys. Property of a material. Right? Different materials will have different resistivity. Clear? Actually, metals have very less resistivity compared to the alloys. See, in your NCERT textbook, one table has been given, right? Metals resistivity, alloys resistivity, plastic, rubbers resistivity. Compare the values. See, again in the metal, one metal has more resistivity, another metal has less resistivity. So, resistivity is nothing but it is a property of a particular material, okay, which is defined as property of a material, which is defined as resistance, which is defined as, it is nothing but resistance only, resistance of a material in a particular dimension is called resistivity. Okay, so this is the definition of resistivity. So what do you mean by this? See, observe the definition carefully. From this line, it is nothing but a resistance of a material, but in a particular dimension. So, what do you mean by a particular dimension? Say, for example, you have some material, copper wire or something. Okay, so how much is the resistance present in this much length of a wire and in this much cross section of a wire? You know, so that resistance is actually called as resistivity. Okay, it is nothing but resistance only. But how much length of a wire? In how much cross section of a wire? Say, if the length of a wire is 1 meter, okay, cross section of a wire is 1 meter square. So in this much cross section, in this much length, the observed resistance is called as resistivity. So resistivity is completely a property of material, whereas resistance is what? Obstruction to the flow of current, disturbances to the flow of current. That disturbances to the flow of current only, resistivity also. But in how much area of a wire in how much length of a wire, right? So this is what we mean by resistivity. Okay, and one thing you have to remember about resistivity as well as resistance, observe carefully. See, note, this you take it as a note because it's very helpful during the calculation, or some conceptual questions can be asked on this concept actually, right? Fine. See, if material is same, if you have same material, okay, but different length and area, different length and different area of cross section, okay, what will happen for the resistivity? Will the resistivity change or will it remain? Say for example, this is a copper wire which is quite lengthy and this is another copper wire which is very short, okay. Say here L is different in both the cases, L is different, whereas A is different, A is different, okay. And you know, what about your resistivity? Resistivity remains the same. Resistivity remains the same here, okay. This is very important point, guys. Okay, see, this wire has a different length and different area of cross section. This has a different length and different area of cross section, but material is same, no? As long as the material remains same, resistivity will not change. Resistivity remains constant. But how about resistance? How about resistance? Will it change or will it remain constant like resistivity? It will not remain constant. Our resistance actually depends on length. Resistance actually depends on area, right? So once the length is changed or area is changed, though both are made up of same material, that is copper, but length is changed, area is changed, so resistance also will change, okay, whereas resistivity will not change. Okay, so this point of difference between resistance and resistivity is very, very, very important. Clear, everybody? So what I will write here, resistance, in this case, what happens? Resistance changes because L and A is changed. Yes or no? Our resistance depends on these factors. So once the length and area changes, though the material is same, you know, resistance also changes. But resistivity will not change because resistivity depends on the nature of material. Material is same, no? So resistivity of this wire and the resistivity of this wire is same, though the length and area is different. Clear? So this is a very important point that you have to remember. So this is what the concept of resistance, factors affecting resistance, formula of resistance, resistivity, formula of resistivity. Okay, now let us discuss few important numericals on this particular concept. Coming to the first problem, resistance of a metal wire of length 1 meter and the resistance is 26 ohms. Ohm in the sense, it's the resistance value they gave you. If diameter of a wire is 0.3 millimeters, what will be the resistivity they are asking? So first, what is given? Given information you write down. So what is given here? Metallic wire of the length, L is given. How much? 1 meter. Okay. Later, resistance R is given, that is 26 ohms. And then diameter D is given, that is 0.3 millimeter. So you can write it as, convert it into standard units, guys. So 0.3 milli in the sense 10 to the power of minus 3 meter. Okay, fine. What they are asking you to calculate, rho is what they are asking you to calculate. So what is the formula of rho here? Formula. Actually, you no need to remember the formula. If you know that R is equal to rho into L by A. So you can write it as rho is equal to Ra by L, isn't it? Say this is what, say if you know the concept, you no need to remember the formula itself. You can derive then and there, right? So this was our formula. This is our formula. So now what we know, R is given, okay, L is given, okay. Yay, area of cross section is nothing but, see that area of cross section is there in the form of circle, right? Area of cross section is nothing but area of circle. Area of circle. So what is the formula of area of circle if diameter is given? So area of circle is equal to, what is the formula? Pi d square by 4, isn't it? So remember this formula, area of circle when diameter is given is equal to pi d square by 4, whereas d is equal to diameter. Pi value you know, 3.14, that is 22 by 7, right? Okay, so now substitute everything here. So what do you get? Rho is equal to R into A is what? Pi d square by 4, right? 4 into L. So this will be your formula. So now substitute the values. R is how much? Where is R? 26 ohms. Pi value is 3.14. You should remember. And diameter is how much? 0.3, okay, into 10 to the power of minus 3 whole square. Okay, so here 0.3 square separately you should do, 10 to the power of minus 3 square separately you should do. Okay, fine. See here, I can again simplify this actually, right? This point, if I shift it here, 3 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meters I can write now, just to make my calculation simple. Okay, see this point I am shifting here, after 3 when I put, what you can write? 10 to the power of minus 1 into 10 to the power of minus 3, 10 to the power of minus 4, right? So what I'll take here, 3 square separately into 10 to the power of minus 4 whole square separately, divided by 4 into L value is how much? Just 1. Okay, so 3 square we know. So rho is equal to 26 into 3.14 into 3 square is 9 into 10 to the power of minus 4. 4 to the 8, minus 8, divided by 4. If you do, how much do you get? You will be getting 183 into 10 to the power of minus 8 ohm meter. Yes or no? So this can be your answer. Or I can also write my answer as, see here, if I put a point, if I put 1.80, okay, if I'll put a point here. So what I can write? Into 10 to the power of 2 into 10 to the power of minus 8, right? So this becomes 1.83 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Yes or no? This is in the form A to the power of m into A to the power of n. So A to the power of m plus n is the formula. So 2 plus of minus 8, that will be minus 6. So ohm meter. Don't forget to write the units, ohm meter. Okay. So this is how you have to calculate. So very important thing here is formula rearrangement is very important. So here it's a direct formula. You no need to rearrange anything. Just try to remember, area of cross section when diameter is given is equal to pi d square by 4. Okay. Whereas area of cross section when radius is given, then area of circle when radius is given, it is just pi r square. Yes or no? Pi r square. That's all about a problem. Come to the next question. Very carefully you have to write the formula here. That's very important. A copper wire has diameter of 0.5 millimeters. First, what is given? Diameter is given 0.5 millimeters. right? So you can write this as 0.5 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter. Okay. And resistivity is given, that is rho is given. How much? 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 8 ohm meters. What is length? L they are asking. Resistance is given. Resistance is 10 ohm. R is given, that is 10 ohms. It's your NCERT exercise question. So L is what they are asking. So what is your main formula? Rho is equal to RA by L. Isn't it? So how do you rearrange this? Again, A is what? A is equal to pi d square by 4. So what you can write? Rho is equal to R pi d square by 4L. Right? So how do you rearrange this? I want L. Okay. So just you write 4L, 4 into L into rho is equal to R into pi into d square, right? What do you want, guys? L is the what you want, right? So R into pi into d square divided by 4 into rho. Okay, so this is your formula for L. So you must know properly how to rearrange a formula. Okay, only then you can get a correct formula. Now all the values you know, just substitute the values here. So how do you substitute? What is R here? R is 10 into pi is 3.14 into d square. What is d? 0.5 square into 10 to the power of minus 3 square, right? Divided by 4 into rho. 4 into rho value is how much? 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 8, right? So if you do, how much do you get? You will be getting around 7.85 into, if you multiply 10 into 3.14 into 0.25, you would be getting 7.85 into 10 to the power of 3 to the 6, minus 6, divided by 4 into 1.6. How much do you get? 4 6 are 24, 4 1s are 4 plus 2 6, 6.4 into 10 to the power of minus 8. Isn't it? So 7.85 divided by 6.4. How much do you get? 1.22 into 10 to the power of minus 6. If this goes up, say 10 to the power of minus 6, I'll bring this up. How much do you get? 10 to the power of 8. So 1.22 into 10 to the power of minus 6 plus 8, 2. Right? 2 L. L they are asking, right? So this much meters. That means, say this point, if I shift here, 122 into 10 to the power of minus 2 into 10 to the power of 2, right? This gets cancelled. So 122 meters is your answer. Okay? So this is how you have to calculate length. So these are two models on resistivity. So few more models I will show at the end of a chapter in case of challenging questions. That's all about today's video. Meet up in the next video to discuss one more important concepts of electricity. Till then, take care. Subscribe our channel to learn the concepts in the easiest way and in a detailed way. Thank you.